we always talked about The Ultimate Life and about doing a sequel. We felt like The Ultimate Gift really was special, and I think that proved to be true. So when it came down to The Ultimate Life, it was just a matter of when.
Ultimate Life builds on the story of The Ultimate Gift, and Jason Stevens has just inherited a $2 billion trust, and his grandfather, Red, built that trust and taught him a lot of great lessons, and Red was a complex guy, a lot of good and a lot of bad, and Jason learned the good lessons, but now he has to overcome some of the bad influences that are creeping into his life and find some balance in The Ultimate Life.
You know, there's something to be said about family movies and about the connection of heritage being passed on to the next and making sure that it's passed on in the right way.
I realized I wanted to know, where did these people come from? Where did Red Stevens and Gus Caldwell and Hamilton, where did they all come from? So I had to go back and find a historical backstory that fit the characters I'd built over the books and the movies.
Through the device of a journal, the Journal of Red Stevens, it becomes a prequel. It takes us back to a young Red Stevens at 16 years old. The first entry in the journal is, "I'm tired of being poor."
He started off in poverty, with his dad saying, "You'll never amount to nothing, we're always gonna be poor." Well, Red didn't accept that. He knew there was something better for him.
He read an article about Andrew Carnegie, and he wanted that same kind of thing.
He has this crazy goal of being a billionaire, and everybody laughs at him and nobody believes in him, but it doesn't deter him. It doesn't get him off of that path. That's what he ends up accomplishing, despite anybody looking down on it, laughing at it. He did it.
He became single-minded towards this one goal, even more so, to succeed, and that he would get it at any costs.
The whole question is brought up, when is enough enough? And in Red's case, it's never enough. There's never too much, there's never enough.
He's got a lot to learn.
As it often happens, you know, the girl stops you dead in your tracks, and same thing happened with Red.
Hannah is the rock. Hannah is the one that holds Red's dream together.
She's the only person that can convince Red of anything.
Red feels that as long as he loves his wife and he provides for his wife, he's doing his job. Everything else is a secondary. The money takes over and he chases it.
He's never home. And she's got four kids to raise basically by herself. She's basically a single mom while he's out there working. And she's at home trying to make ends meet.
He doesn't look at the consequences of not being there.
I think the focus gets lost.
He achieves all of his goals. He makes his $1 billion. Then he realizes he's absolutely empty.
And then when he has this epiphany, it does renew a little bit faith in his family and in himself to become this better person that he knows he needs to be.
Flaws we find in Jason now is that a few years later, he's become the same workaholic that Red was.
He kind of reverts back a little bit to the old Jason, but having Alexia, I think, has kind of made him really have to decide who he wants to be and who he's going to be for the rest of his life.
When Emily passed, I think she was left with an emptiness that she wasn't sure how to fill. And Jason's this busy guy, you know, he's an entrepreneur, he's now running a foundation that he created for she and Emily, and she's very touched by that, but at the same time, trying to figure out, where does she belong in his life, and does he need her?
He definitely feels a lot of responsibility to make sure that what Red has left him is moving forward, and I think he puts that ahead of himself and Alexia and what they had created in the first movie.
So he's learning how to deal with responsibility and how to deal with love and how to deal with the 12 gifts that his grandfather gave him.
He realizes there's another lesson from Red that he learns, Ken, and that's the value of family, the value of relationship. It's
first was asked about appearing in the film, I asked, who's going to be the director? And when they said Michael Landon Jr., I went, oh, good. Oh, I would love to work with him.
I would work with him any day. He is an actor's dream. He lets you play. You know, he puts you in an environment. He sees what you do, and he just tweaks it.
He knows exactly what to say at any point to get you into the mode.
He's very lighthearted about things, which I think brings a great atmosphere to the set.
He's very calm and he's very direct.
I've worked with Michael before on a few films, and I feel he knows how to talk to me as an actor, and he knows how to help me do the best that I can and bring out the best of me. You know, if I'm struggling in a scene, I always look to Michael to have the one thing that I can't think of to get me there. And he's always there for me. He's a very giving director in that way.
He's an all-around incredible director. He knows exactly what he wants. He knows how to get it. And he knows how to get it out of people, which is exciting to me.
80% of what a director does is casting. So far what I have seen, he cast really well.
It's a love story, it's an adventure, just as the other was, just as The Ultimate Gift was.
There's a lot of families out there that can relate to this movie.
There's so many different ideas and different thoughts. I think it's one of those movies that everyone's gonna take away something different.
This film really inspires and puts everything into perspective and shows you the good and the bad.
However much you might wanna be famous or be successful and have a lot of money, the relationships that you leave and the memories that you leave are the only things that are going to be left when you go.
Don't be afraid to dream. Don't be afraid to live and dream big.
It's always important to realize that it's never too late. And the only way to realize it's never too late is start trusting.
In today's world, there are so many different paths you can follow. There are so many different directions you can choose, and I think it's easy to get off on the wrong foot, go the wrong way, make bad decisions, but it's really important to know you can always come back.
Even if you feel like you're stepping in the wrong direction, you feel like you're becoming somebody you're not supposed to be, there's always a chance, there's always a hope that you can find your way again.
I'm really excited that we're gonna have the opportunity later this year to bring that to the big screen and then make it available around the world.
It's inspirational, it's uplifting. Instead of dragging you down, it brings you up. And I think that's something that's a bit rare and that is special.
It's okay to have a dream and a goal. It's okay to believe in those dreams and goals. And it's okay to chase after them. But doing so, don't forget the most important thing in life, and that's living it. I mean, that's truly living it.